Hello friends and welcome to Average Classes. So today we are going to solve the swimming pool, boat and the anchor problem. Okay, it is quite interesting. Okay, and yes, exam point of view also they ask, but mostly interview questions they will ask this. Okay, so now let us dive into this lecture. So we have a swimming pool. Okay, and I have kept a boat in a swimming pool. Why, sir? I'll tell you why. Just imagine I have kept the boat in the swimming pool. Now, this is not enough for me. What I have done on the boat, I have now kept an anchor. As if the boat is going somewhere. Inside the swimming pool only. Okay. So, this is the question. Okay, you have a swimming pool. In the swimming pool, you have a boat. And on the boat, you have an anchor. Okay. Understood? Now, the question is, what will happen to the liquid level? Initially, let us say this is the liquid level. Okay. HI. Initially, let us say this is the liquid level occupied, you know, right? Swimming pool was empty. I wanted to do some mischief. So, I took a boat and kept on the swimming pool. I am so powerful. I lifted the boat and I kept on the swimming pool. Because of I kept the boat on the swimming pool, there is some amount of water it will try to displace. Okay, what will be the water displaced? Sir, it's the volume of the boat itself. Okay, so that much of amount of water it has displaced. Means the pool, the water level has rose up. Okay, na? Let us say this much of the depth it has covered initially. Now, what I want to do is, I want to take this anchor out. Okay. The first case, I'll pull the anchor out and I'll drop it in the swimming pool itself. Where I'll drop it? In the swimming pool itself. The question is, what will be the change in this depth, water level here? Okay. That is number one. Number two, now so for the second question, I am not dropping it in the liquid only. I am too powerful. I lift the anchor and I threw it somewhere out on the ground itself. Okay, I have threw it somewhere on the ground. Again, then what will happen to the liquid level? So, that is the question we are going to discuss. Interesting. Already interested. I know you guys are very, very smart and enthusiastic students. Very good. So, now let us go for the solution. Okay, before that, let us say VIW. VIW is the initial volume. Initial volume of displaced water to keep the boat floating. Okay, now so let us say volume is VIW, then what is WIW? Weight of the displaced volume. Weight of the displaced volume. But sir, you didn't tell us why you took a swimming pool. See, the reason of taking swimming pool is it's a controlled volume. So, I can apply my fluid mechanics concept here. The volume is very much controlled here. Okay, that is one of the reason. Next, you have took a swimming pool so that you can also assume the weight of the width of the swimming pool. Okay, yahan par thoda diagram idhar dikh raha hai. But the width of the swimming pool is actually more than the width of the boat. So, this is the two reasons we have took swimming pool. One is for control volume. Because it's control volume, our fluid mechanics, whatever we are studying is for control volume for never only. It becomes a little easier for us to solve. So, what the weight of this displaced volume is WIW. Okay. Now, let us say VA. What is VA, sir? Volume of anchor. Volume of anchor. Okay. Then, sir, you write weight also. Yes. This is weight of the anchor. Weight of the anchor. Now, okay, this much is done. Now, this boat is what? Floating. Boat is what? Floating. Means inside the boat you have anchor. So, the weight of the anchor must be equal to weight of the displaced volume of water. No, sir, we didn't understand. Okay. See, it's like this. One side, you have gone to a shop and you have asked for 5 kilo of sugar. How much? 5 kilo of sugar. So, in the weighing balance. So, think of a weighing balance. Okay. Weighing balance what? We want to weigh 5 kilo of sugar. How your shopkeeper will do? Okay, he'll take an iron weight of 5 kilo. On the next side, he'll start pouring your 5 kilo amount of sugar. So, what you understood, sir, weight on both the sides are same only. Weight on your left hand side and weight on the right hand side are same only. So, what is the difference? volume is the difference. What is the difference? Volume is the difference. That means a 5 kilo of your whey occupies, which is made up of iron, which occupies less volume. Whereas your 5 kilo of sugar occupies more volume. Are you getting my point? Similarly, when the anchor was on inside the boat, so the displaced volume of water, to measure to the weight of your anchor was more. See, anchor, how much volume it occupies? Anchor volume, less. Okay, but the equivalent amount of water, more volume. Anchor is like your weighing on the weighing balance. Okay, and your water is like sugar. So, in order to balance the weight of the anchor, water has to be displaced more. Sir, why? Because it is floating, otherwise it won't float. We have already discussed. If the body is in floating, the weight of the water displaced and the buoyancy force, they are same. Or the weight of the water displaced and the weight of the body is same. That's why only it is floating. That's why there is no apparent weight. Are you getting my point? Okay. So that's why the weight of the anchor must be equal to the weight of the water displaced. But the volume of water will be much more compared to the volume of your anchor. Okay. So that means weight of your anchor must be equal to weight of the water displaced. This is initial condition. When the anchor is inside the boat, this condition is when the boat is floating. Okay. Now this implies weight means what, sir? Weight means mass into gravity. M into G. Super. M into, so M A G is equal to M I W G. Super. Now M A means what, sir? Density. That is your density of anchor. Volume of anchor. G is equal to density of water. Volume of water displaced multiply G. Now simple, G and G are cancelled. So this implies density of anchor upon density of water, density of anchor upon density of water is equal to volume of water displaced upon volume of anchor. I got one equation. This equation I needed. Clear? I needed this equation. Now, if you excuse me, I want to erase it. So, I hope you have noted this. Okay. Superb. Very, very interesting. They ask in interviews. This kind of question you can always expect in interviews or in EAC. Okay. In your school exam, sometimes they ask. Okay. Now, see. But we know the density of anchor is more than the density of water. Okay, anchor is made up of steel. Let us say it's steel. So obviously its specific gravity is 7.85. Water specific gravity is 1. So obviously density of anchor is more than your density of water. Because the density of anchor is more than density of water, this implies the volume of displaced water must be greater than the volume of anchor. That's what we discussed. The sugar volume is always more than the volume of the whey. So this we have now understood. Okay. When the anchor was inside the boat, because of that, the displaced volume of water is more than the volume of the anchor itself. Okay. Now what I have done? I have took the anchor out and dropped in the water. How much? Dropped in the water. So now, how much volume the anchor will occupy? Sir, the volume of anchor now it will occupy is its own volume only. So this implies area into HIW. Okay, this was my HIW E greater than area HA. Okay, this implies area of the boat. Okay, HIW is greater than H anchor. So that means the level of water. The level of water when the anchor was inside the boat is more than the level of water when the anchor is not on the boat. Wherever anchor, this anchor may be downside in the water, or this anchor you might have thrown in the ground itself. So in both the cases, the height of the or the level of liquid, is more when the anchor is inside the boat compared to when the anchor is outside the boat. So what will happen? So HA, now in the present your HA, when this anchor you will throw out, when the anchor is thrown out or dropped, what will happen? The liquid level will decrease. This is your HA now. So what will happen to the liquid level? Sir, the liquid level will drop. Or the level of liquid, they ask it, what happens to the water level in the pool? The water level in the pool will come down. Or lower down. In both the cases. In case A and case B. In case A, at least some HA is there. Like some amount of volume is there. In case B, you have thrown it out only. So this much only, it will arise, it will come up. Means which will come up? Boat will come up, water level will come down. See, so listen to the question what they are asking. They are asking what will happen to the boat or what will happen to the water level. If they are saying what will happen to the boat, boat will come up. Okay? And what will happen to the liquid? Level of your liquid, the water level will come down. Okay? I hope you understood. Interesting, isn't it? Any such questions you have, you wanted to know more and all, please write in the comment section. We will discuss. I am more enthusiastic to solve your doubts which are thought provoking. Okay, and I am blessed with some fantastic audience out there. Okay, so now little change it. Sometimes they'll ask, now what will happen? Instead of this anchor, I'll take some lighter material like a cork and all, and I'll throw. See, in my boat I have so many objects. Let us say I have an object which is very light. Okay, this only. I'll go and I'll throw it. So what will happen? That will float. This anchor sinks and comes to bottom of the pool. But what if something is floating? What will happen to the level of water? Same. Because your boat is floating, you took that out and also you kept on the swimming pool and it is floating, then no change in the water level. As long as it is floating, no change in the water level. If it sinks or if you throw it out, okay, water level comes down. Okay, so this is Average Classes for you. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe, like and share these interesting videos with your friends. Okay, have a great day ahead.